Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Top Rank conference call with Brandon Rios. If you would like to ask a question, please press the number one key. Your host today, Fred Sternburn, will begin.
Thanks so much. Welcome, everybody. We're pleased to bring to you today from their training camp at the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy in Oxnard, California. We've got former world champion Brandon Bam Bam Rios with us, as well as his trainer of the year, Robert Garcia, and Hall of Fame promoter Bob Arum. We're here today to discuss their training camp and their plans for their upcoming historic battle against Manny Pacquiao and Freddie Roach, which will be at the Venetian Macau on November 23 and seen live on via HBO pay-per-view at 9 p.m. East Coast time that night. Before we begin the call, I want to remind people, actually just inform people, that this Thursday, Brandon will be hosting his only U.S. media workout at the gym. That's at the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy in Oxnard. And the address is 1451 Pacific Avenue, and I will be sending out an alert later today on that. That begins at 12 noon. And joining Brandon and Robert at their workout on Thursday will be Kevin Hart, who is starring in the upcoming Warner Brothers movie Grudge Match. That will also be starring Sylvester Stallone and Robert De Niro. And Kevin will also be available for interviews, as will Bob Arum. So without any further ado, it's my pleasure to introduce to you Hall of Fame promoter Bob Arum, fresh from his trip back from the Philippines. Bob?
Yeah, hello, everybody. I don't know if it's morning or night or whatever it is, but Fred and I got back from the Philippines last night, and in time for this conference call with Brandon Rios and Robert Garcia. Everybody is pumped and ready to go. The buzz in Asia is just tremendous. Manny's media day was attended by 70 news people from all over China, Hong Kong, Macau, Singapore. So now we ship the focus to America and Brandon Rios, and we're happy to have him on the conference call today, and look forward to the media day on Thursday in Oxnard.
Thank you, Bob, and also like to let people know joining Brandon, Bob, and Robert Garcia is Brandon's manager, Cameron Duncan. If anyone has any questions for Cameron, he is available as well. Brandon, welcome to the call. How's training camp going?
Training, thank you guys for calling me. But anyways, the training camp is going great. It's been awesome, and okay, I say I have a good training camp. It's not one of the best training camps I had, but it's a good training camp. I'm just ready to go out there and do what I got to do.
Robert, I know you're planning on leaving with Brandon around the 11th, I believe, to go to Macau to get acclimated to Macau, the time zone difference, and the climate and everything. Anything out of the ordinary going on in training camp in preparation for this fight?
No, it's not, Fred. Everything's going great. You know, we've been having a great training camp. We've had great sparring partners. We have the whole team already ready to leave on the 11th. We got the whole, you know, everybody, you know, from the cook to sparring partners ready to travel with us on the 11th. So we're excited about this trip and excited definitely about this fight.
Well, terrific. I know everyone's excited and anticipating this great event. So, Katina, why don't we give instructions to the media on how to ask questions, please?
Ladies and gentlemen, if you have any questions at this time, please press the number one key. Again, if you have any questions at this time, please press the number one key.
While we're waiting for the reporters to get into queue, for both Brandon and Robert, how easy or how hard has it been to train for a full-blown welterweight fight as opposed to the lighter weights that you've been used to in the past? Brandon, you first.
Well, you know, it's been good. You know, it's been really great just transferring my body to welterweight. I don't have to kill myself to make 140, even though I wasn't, to make 135 like I was before. Actually, it's going to suit me very well, and I feel great. And honestly, I feel very strong still. I don't feel like the weight's going to be a factor or nothing like that. It's going to actually help me out a lot.
Robert, have you seen any difference in Brandon at the heavier weight?
he's feeling a lot more comfortable this time. You know, come out of the fight, this time of the fight, three, four weeks before the fight, he was already cutting weight and it was already hurting him and his performances in the gym. Nowadays, those 7 pounds is not going to hurt him at all. You know, that's actually going to benefit him. He's going to be stronger. He's going to be faster because he's not cutting weight like he normally does when he was doing 135 or even 140. So right now the training is on our game plan and how to beat Manny Pacquiao and not to make weight. So the weight is actually going to benefit Brandon at 147.
Great. Okay, Katina, we're ready for questions.
Okay, our first question is going to come from Dan Raffia from ESPN. Please go ahead.
Thank you very much. Hello, Brandon. How you doing, Robert? Good to talk
Hi,
to you guys. Brandon, one of the things I want to ask you about is, Manny will have been off for quite some time since the loss in December to Matt Pacquiao, to Marquez, a very, very hard knockout. I wonder, does part of you, you're an aggressive fighter, does part of you just want to just go in there and jump on him right away to see how he might react after such a brutal knockout in his last fight, maybe catch him, thinking a little bit about what happened last time he was in the ring?
No, we cannot do that. We cannot go in there and think that he could be done from the last knockout. We don't know how he is. I don't know personally. So we don't know what could we expect. What we got to do is just go in there calm and just wait and wait and wait and see what he has, because he's still a dangerous opponent no matter what. Pacquiao's always going to be dangerous what he does. So I cannot go in there and just think I'm going to jump on him and see if he's done with. I'm not thinking like that. I'm going in there with a great game plan. Robert has a great game plan. His dad also is helping us out. So we have a great game plan going in the fight. So I got to follow the instruction and stick to the game plan, and I think we should be ready.
Robert, what do you think about the thought that some might think maybe the best thing would be to just try to jump on him right away, given the long layoff and what happened in his last fight?
Well, my dad and myself, we thought about the game plan and we watched the videos and we've been watching the fights together, and it's definitely something that everybody expects us to do, and we might just go out and do it, because we don't know what Pacquiao is coming out, but we also got to do it smart. We can't just jump in and try to think that we're the stronger, that we're the faster, that we're the better guys that night. No, we got to be ready for the best Pacquiao out there. We know he's training like never before, because he's got a lot. For him, it's do or die. So we got to be ready for the best Pacquiao. We can't go in there thinking that it's going to be an easy fight. We got to be ready for a great, difficult fight. And our game plan is turning out really good. Brandon followed instructions. Brandon is listening to everything we tell him to do, and the sparring partners are being very helpful. So we should come out, with good results.
My other question for you guys, both of you, if you could chime in on this. The fight's going to take place, you're going to go a couple weeks ahead of time to get acclimated to the time change. So when you actually get in the ring and fight, it's going to be morning time in China, totally different than what you're used to. It's going to be the normal, nighttime in the United States. How are you planning to address the time change as far as your training, being prepared to fight a fight that's going to probably go in the ring, 11 o'clock in the morning, as opposed to when you're normally fighting, at nighttime, if you're on the West Coast, 8:30 in the evening. Have you guys discussed that, and what do you think about that?
The fact that we're fighting in the morning, it is different because we have never done that. We have never fought in the morning. So it's something that is not only for ourselves, but everybody fight on the same card. It's something new to everybody. But one thing that we've always done with Brandon is Brandon always trains at that time anyways. Brandon is always in the gym at 11, by 12 he's already sparring and already doing his work. So that's something we always do anyway. So I think it's actually gonna probably benefit us, because we're already used to doing that. We go back to China 2 weeks and we're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna be training early so we could get used to the change.
Brandon, what do you think about having a fight in the morning instead of at night? I mean, it is a lot different, like Robert was saying.
Well, it's going to be different, but it's nothing. Once you get in the ring and you're ready to fight, that's all you think about. You think about a fight. You're not going to think about, it's too early for me. I'm not going to be able to perform the way I used to. No. Honestly, yes, it's in the morning, but to me, I'm just ready to fight. I'm ready to get it on. I'm ready to show the world that what I can do when I'm in top shape and when I'm in have the best training camp ever, and when I come in mentally and physically ready, I just want to show everybody what they expected from me.
All right. Thank you very much, guys. Good luck to you guys.
Thank you.
Our next question is going to come from Michael Woods from Sweet Science. Please go ahead.
Hi, guys. Thanks for taking the time to do the call. Freddie, you got in my question about the weight going from 135 and 140 to 147. Brandon seems to say that it's going to do him good. Brandon, I am wondering, this promotion is a mega promotion. And when you guys visited China, you were, you know, kind of friendly with Manny and stuff. Are you finding yourself getting, though, your game face on and getting a little bit more, a little bit more irked, getting a little bit angry, a little bit fired up now, getting closer to the fight? Is your game face on?
I always have my game face on. I never, in China, you know, it was promotion. We really didn't talk as much to each other. But the only time we seen each other, we talked, yes. Show the respect to each other, show the sports respect. I'm always having my game face on. Right when Cameron called me, told me I'm the fighter that's going to fight Pacquiao, the game went on already. So I'm ready to fight.
Okay. And Bob, you're still on the line?
Yeah, I am.
Bob, could you talk a little bit about Brandon, the personality, and what you've seen from him? It seems like he's, certainly in this promotion, matured a little bit. He's 27. He's had some problems making weight, a couple other fights. But Brandon, the personality, what you've seen from him thus far?
Well, Brandon is, you know, somebody who is really a credit to boxing because he has a great friendly fan-friendly personality. You know that if you're watching a Brandon Rios fight, you're going to see a real fight. He has a big, big heart, and he brings a lot of energy into a fight. And I think he complements Pacquiao in this fight. They're both high-energy fighters, and I think we're going to see a tremendous, tremendous battle between two guys who love to fight and know when they get in the ring that that's what's expected of them.
And Bob, last thing, you have said months prior that says, you know, we're gonna know how well this does when it plays out. But are you getting indications of how it's trending as far as ticket sales and that sort of thing? Is this as much of a risk now doing this as Macau as in as versus Las Vegas? Are you pretty
there is no risk, to be honest about you. The Macau fight, it'll be sold out. There'll be thousands more in Macau watching on closed circuit, as in Hong Kong, as in the Venetian in Las Vegas. So that aspect is all covered. The television all over Asia, China, Korea, Indonesia, Malaysia, Australia, is going to set records for viewership. And in the United States, we believe that with the campaign we're going to have, that the pay-per-view figures in the United States will be right there. Because I'm glad you really raised this question,
yeah.
Because what we intend to do on Fight Week is at the Venetian in Las Vegas, we're going to have all the radio remotes there. We're bringing in top fighters to talk to the radio people. We're going to do everything at the Venetian Las Vegas as if the fight was in Las Vegas.
Okay. All right. Thanks. Appreciate it, guys. Good luck. Have a great fight.
Thank you.
And our next question is going to come from Jenna Jay on the ropes boxing. Please go ahead.
Hi, guys. How are you guys doing today?
Good, good. Yourself?
Good. I'm doing very good. Brandon, the question I have for you is, the last time that you faced a southpaw in the ring was Joel Ortega when you were 19. Why has it been so long since you faced a southpaw?
Because we haven't had a southpaw opponent yet, that's why. Honestly, I don't even know. We just haven't had somebody that's southpaw yet, so lately, it's okay. That's not going to make any difference. Maybe I need something new, different, something to look at different now. So always looking at a right-handed, now we got to look at a left-handed. So feeling better.
Now, Brendan, you know, throughout the promotion, when you listen to a lot of media, there's been a lot of people not giving you much of a chance in this fight, and I'm wondering, from your perspective, do you think that's unfair? I mean, your only loss is a close decision loss, and Pacquiao's coming off of a knockout. why do you think people aren't giving you much of a answer for them?
Excuse me, what was that again?
Then why do you think people aren't giving you much of a chance in this fight, even though you only have one defeat that is close?
You know, it's okay. Everybody's looking at me as a punching bag, a walking forward guy. It's all right. You know, me and Robert, we have a great game plan. We're going in with something. We're going to go in small. We're going to shock the world. We're going to show them a different side of Brandon. So we're just ready, man. Those are people that, to me, honestly, I don't really care if they don't think I got a chance or not. You know, I'm just going to show them all wrong, prove them all, everybody wrong. And that's good. They don't think I'm, they're not giving me credit. That makes me train even harder and give me that more of a drive to show them, to shut them up.
You enjoy being an underdog, Brandon?
I love it. I love it being an underdog because I want them to, you know, I love it when they think they doubt me. Because when you doubt me, I prove you guys wrong all the time. I did it once, I proved wrong with the Peterson. I did it again with Acosta, I proved wrong with Acosta. I did it with Antion, I proved wrong with Antion. I did it with Alvarado, I proved wrong with Alvarado. So, we're ready.
Okay, our next question is going to come from Lem Satterfeld from RingTV.com. Please go ahead.
Brandon, how you doing?
I'm doing good, yourself?
I'm doing well. I was reading the camp notes today, and your camp notes ended with you saying, "This is not Pacquiao's fight. It's Pacquiao versus Rios. And I will let the world know that on November 23rd. I guess you feel the promotion has been packaged so that you're kind of the B-side fighter or perceived to be. What elements of this do you see that in? What makes you feel like that?
Well, you know, the reason why I said it is not just Pacquiao fight. Pacquiao's not just fighting himself, he's fighting Rios because everybody's giving me no chance. Everybody's ready to mark me out, they're overlooking me. So I just want to show the world that, I just want to let him know that he's in there with the live dog. He's not in there with just a little puppy. He's in there with a live dog. He's in there to go in there and show the world that he belongs to fight the best. He wants to be the best, and he wants to fight the best. This is the guy that has heart and balls that gives everything in the ring. That's what he wants.
I mean, what gives you that indication? What have you read? What have you seen? What do you perceive about... You know, what evidence do you have that people aren't giving you a chance?
There's a lot of them, man. I've been hearing articles. I've been hearing all kinds of stuff, man. I don't need to go out and keep saying it, but there's a lot of stuff out there. There's a lot of people out there, a lot of fucking the best boxing, people that know boxing the best, whatever. Everybody's out there saying it, so it's okay, man. I just wanted to go out there and shut everybody up and prove them wrong.
There's also a perception that you were sort of selected as an opponent by Pacquiao because he thinks he can look good against you. Maybe he doesn't expect you to box. Maybe he expects you to be there to be hit, and maybe because you're smaller. Do you believe that he thinks he's going to get in there and beat up essentially on a smaller guy?
Smaller guy? If you say he's small, I'm smaller. At the press conference, I believe he was smaller than me, so I'm not the smaller guy here. So, if you're going at that, then your eyes are deceiving because I'm not smaller than Pacquiao. Pacquiao's smaller than me. And
yeah, that's a good point Brandon raises, Bob. Pacquiao is the much smaller guy.
Mm-hmm.
Brandon towers over Pacquiao. He's much bigger than Pacquiao. And as far as the weight is concerned, I mean, that's one of Freddie's biggest problems. Manny is working so hard, he's so light, that he's eating five meals a day in order to keep his weight. In other words, he's probably now 5 pounds under the welterweight limit.
So, Bob, you actually think that Brandon is physically the bigger guy?
Not, I think, I know. He's much bigger than Pacquiao. He's taller, his reach is bigger, and he probably today weighs more, weighs probably 10 pounds more than Pacquiao does. Right, Brandon? You're probably about 152 today?
Yep.
Yeah, something like that. And Manny was 142 when I left him in Jensen.
I got one last question for Brandon and for Robert. Again, the perception is, I believe, the general perception is that Brandon is not going to box or have the ability to box. I don't mean that in a harsh way, but I think that's perception. Number one, is that an incorrect perception? And B, do you think that boxing is a concession on behalf of Brandon?
Who's that answer for me or Robert?
Both of you.
You first, Brandon.
Go ahead, Robert.
Okay, you first, Robert.
You know what? I think that if we were getting ready to outbox Manny, it would sort of be something new to Brandon. Everybody knows what Brandon fights. Everybody knows how he fights, and ain't nothing going to change Brandon. Brandon is always been the brawler, and that's what we're going to do in this fight. We're going to go out there and do, to make it into a brawl, and that's the way, the only way Brandon can fight, and that's the only way Brandon knows how to fight. So there's, you know, there's nothing else we could do. That's what we have.
Brandon?
You heard it from the man, Robert, and he's the one that's training me, so I got to go with Robert. I'm going to stick with what Robert said. That's what's going to happen.
Hey, you said you're going to be a dog. You said you're a big dog, not a puppy. What kind of dog are you going to be? A pit bull, a Great Dane, what?
I'm a pit bull mixed with the Great Dane, mixed with the Rottweiler, mixed with the Bull Terrier, mixed with the half horse, mixed with everything, man. Any dog you think, that's the kind of dog I am.
Thanks a lot. I appreciate it. Good luck.
That's like a hot dog.
Just
but
as a
that's enough. Next question.
Just as a reminder, if you would like to ask a question, press the number one key. Our next question is going to come from Jake Donovan from theboxingscene.com. Please go ahead.
Hey, Brandon. I just wanted to know how long Pacquiao has realistically been on your radar. I say he's the big payday. Everybody wants to fight him. But I'm just thinking like 3 years ago, you were a fight away from fighting for the lightweight title when Antonio Margarito was fighting Pacquiao. Like, was he on your radar even way back then?
Man. You know, he hasn't been on radar that long. You know, it's pretty, you know, at that time, you know, I wasn't ready for these type of fights. Now, I think I matured a lot. Robert got me to the point where I need to be, and he feels that I've grown. Cameron Duncan feels that I've grown, and that I can compete at this level now. So now it's time to be at this level. So now I feel like I'm ready for these type of fights.
I'm ready. Okay. And I know
question.
You don't want to.
That's the question.
Yeah, it does.
Now. That's the question. I'm ready now.
Okay, cool. I hear you, man. Thanks. I just want to know, with Mike Alvarado, I know somewhere in the back of your mind, I would think you would want to avenge that loss. Even though you beat him, he's still the man that hung the only loss on you. Win or lose against Manny Pacquiao, was a third fight still on your radar, and does that change any with his most recent loss to Provodnikov?
Oh, no, you know what? This is what I say, and I always tell this to everybody. There's only one guy on my mind right now, that's Manny Pacquiao. There's only one guy that's going to be on my mind is Manny Pacquiao. I don't look over any opponent because all fighters are dangerous. Every fighter is dangerous. So I look about only one opponent at a time, and that's Manny Pacquiao right now. After the fight, then we can talk business, and I'll sit down with Cameron Duncan and Robert, and we'll go over some great options for me.
Okay, and then my final question. I don't want to delve too much into drug testing because I know it's going to take in a different direction. I just want to know, do you see it being a part of your future, like all future fights? Are you going to participate in random drug testing? Or is this just a unique situation?
Hey, you know what? Honestly, I'm a clean fighter. I don't really need a drug testing, but hey, they want a drug testing for this fight, so why not? I didn't ask for it. So if they want a drug testing, we can do it. But if they don't want one, it's okay. It's not like I'm going to fight them for it. Hey, I'm a clean fighter, like I said. If they're not clean, it's okay. If they're clean, it's okay. I'm just worrying about me and my camp, what we do, and that's it.
Okay, great. Thanks a lot, Brandon. Best of luck next month.
Thank you.
Our next question is going to come from Daniel Olea from Zona Deportiva. Please go ahead.
¿Qué tal, Brando, Robert? Muy buenas tardes.
Buenas tardes, ¿cómo estás?
Una pregunta para ti primero, Brandon. Tanto tú como Pacquiao vienen de una derrota. ¿Consideras que una segunda derrota en tu carrera esfumaría las posibilidades o tus sueños de ser campeón mundial?
Ah, sí, así es. Yo quiero otra vez, ahorita necesito ganar de Pacquiao primero y ya está listo para lo que sea en la frente de mí. Ahorita Robert está hace cosas muy bien en el gimnasio y no más listo.
Robert, Brandon, could you just translate the question and your response, please?
I said, yes, I feel good, and I'm ready for a champion, and I'm ready to fight any guy in front of me. But first, we got to defeat Pacquiao, and after that, and Robert's been doing everything in the gym right. He's doing everything, training me hard, so we'll be ready.
Okay, y este es para Robert. Robert, el hecho de tener a Alex Ariza en su esquina, por el hecho de conocer a Pacquiao, ¿les da ventaja?
No, ninguna ventaja. Mira, el primero que nada, Alex Ariza no va a estar en la esquina. Está trabajando en el campamento, pero no va a estar en la esquina. La esquina la vamos a trabajar yo, mi papá y nuestro Carmen. Así es que eso es lo que quiero tener bien claro, que la gente sepa bien claro que la esquina va a ser trabajada por mi papá, yo y el doctor Anderson. Aparte de eso, el hecho de que él ya trabajó con el Pacquiao no quiere decir nada. O sea, nosotros estamos en nuestro trabajo. No estoy, yo en ningún instante le he preguntado o le he pedido cosas de cómo trabajaba, qué hacía él, qué no hacía, ninguna, porque eso no es ninguna cosa que yo tengo que pedir. Yo estoy haciendo mi trabajo y él está haciendo su trabajo con Brandon y vamos a prepararlo lo mejor que nunca, pero no estoy yo pensando en que porque él trabaja con Pacquiao ya hay una ventaja.
Hey, Robert, translate the question and answer, okay?
Yeah, the question was the fact that we have Alex Ruiz in the corner, if that's going to change something through the fact that he also was with Pacquiao. And the first thing I made clear is that Ariza is not in the corner. Ariza is working with Brandon, but he will not be working the corner. The corner will be myself, my dad, and Dr. Anderson, who is our cutman. The fact that he has worked with Pacquiao before, that doesn't mean that we're taking advantage of anything. I haven't even asked him questions about Pacquiao. That was their deal with when they did it together. And Ariza hasn't been challenging me or trying to look for things that Pacquiao should do and that we have to do now or that he's not doing. No, I don't ask questions. He doesn't tell me anything. We're just doing our job like if we had never worked with Pacquiao in the past.
Good, thanks.
These pizza rabbits are cabrón, güey.
I think we got time for one more questioner, if we can get one more in.
And our next question is going to come from James Meyer from The Boxing Voice. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thanks a lot for taking my questions. I just had a couple quick questions for Brandon. The first one would be kind of leeching off that last question, is how has the addition of Alex Ariza impacted your camp, and what's that relationship like?
Well, you know what? He's been coming at me. Because I'm already a physically strong guy as it is, but Ariza is, he got some good work ethics. He's making me faster. He's making me more lighter on my feet and everything. It's been great. You know, he's been working very well. Like Robert said, too, we have not asked him once, what does Pacquiao does wrong, what this weakness, nothing like that. We're not fucking, we don't need none of that stuff. We work and just hard work and get the job done. That's what we do. And the reason, you know, he's great. You know, he just, he does his workout very well and he does a great job at it. Mikey's using him, I'm using him, and we see difference. We see great results.
Awesome. Okay, so then my next question would be for both Brandon and Robert. So Pacquiao is on a higher level than maybe what you guys are used to with your past opponents. Are you expecting the same Pacquiao to come into the ring, or are you expecting a more hesitant, cautious Pacquiao to kind of start the fight?
I'm ready for the Pacquiao that was dominating the game. That's the guy I'm ready for. I'm not looking at his last fight when he got knocked out by Marquez. That could have happened to anybody. It could have happened to me. Well, so we cannot go into the all Pacquiao done. He's old overnight. He's done already. This and that. No, I'm not looking at it like that. I'm looking at the Pacquiao that was dominating the game. So I'm getting the best shape I can get, and I'll be ready mentally and physically ready for this fight. And if he starts off slow, great. That even gives me more time to warm up. Starts off fast, great. That means I got to warm up faster. So we'll be ready.
All right, that's all the questions I have. Thanks, guys.
All right, well, I think we're going to wrap it up. It's been a really good call. I know they've had a hard day in the gym already, and so we're going to let Brandon rest up here. I do want to remind everybody in the L.A. area that this Thursday, Brandon and Robert will be hosting a media workout at the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy, and that's at 1451 Pacific Avenue in Oxnard. That'll start at noon, and also joining them will be Bob Arum, as well as Kevin Hart, who is starring in the upcoming Warner Brothers picture Grudge Match. And Kevin will also be available for interviews as well. So it should be a lot of fun. And I believe coming up in about, just next week, we got 24/7 Pacquiao Rios debuts Saturday, November 9. And that's immediately following the Boxing After Dark triple header from Corpus Christi, promoted by Top Rank as well. So, Bob, I'll let you have a few last words here before we go to Brandon.
Yeah, I want to thank everybody for being on the call. I'm glad you mentioned this great triple header that we have November 9th. Robert's brother, Mikey Garcia, challenges for the 130-pound title against Rocky Martinez. Donair in a grudge match with Darchinian, and Vanas Medrosian against Andrade for the junior middleweight title. A terrific, terrific offering on HBO. These two fighters, both Manny Pacquiao and Brandon Rios, have really been training hard for this fight. And I want to address one question, the idea of them fighting in the morning. Remember, one of the greatest fights that I ever saw took place 38 years ago in Manila in the morning at the same time when Joe Frazier and Muhammad Ali went at it in one of the great fights in the history of boxing. I expect a great fight here in the morning in Macau, Saturday evening, usual time in Las Vegas. And let me say this. You know, people say, well, fighting in the morning, how unusual. Yeah, it's unusual. But ask yourself, when you have the most energy and the most strength, is it in the morning or is it in the evening? And most people will say it's in the morning. So that's why I expect an even greater battle than if the fight was taking place at the usual time in the evening.
Thank you, Bob. And again, even though the fight's in the morning in Macau, it will be seen live at its normal pay-per-view time, 9 p.m. East Coast time, 6 p.m. West Coast time on Saturday, November 23. Robert, any final words from training camp?
Everything's good. Just see you guys in Macau in a couple of weeks.
All right. Brandon, we'll leave the last words to you.
Well, I just want to quote one person, Kevin Hart. All right. Yeah. Get ready for Macau, bitches. Yeah. I just think, guys, it's been a great call, and thank you, guys, and we'll be ready 100%. We're going to give the fans and everybody the TV a great fight, and it's going to be a great fight for everybody around the world, and it's going to see two warriors going at it, and they really do go at it, and it's going to be a great fight, and I just want to say thanks to everybody that
thanks,
me,
Brandon. Robert, thank you. Bob, thank you. And I want to thank everyone for joining us. And hopefully we'll see everybody Thursday at Brandon's media workout at Robert's gym. It'll be his only U.S. media workout. So I hope everyone can take advantage of it. You're in for a treat. He's in great shape. And I know he's going to put on a great show this Thursday. And otherwise, we'll see everyone in Macau. And we'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.
Bye.